When you're in the observatory, it feels like you're in a choose-your-own-adventure, and the sky is all the different options that you have. You have the ability to go to any location in space, any location in time. To say you're boldly going where no one has ever gone before, that's really what astronomers do. You're an explorer. Here at the Space Center, our main objective is basically to inspire wonder and curiosity about space for everyone that passes through our doors. My job here as the astronomer is to basically be the source of astronomy knowledge for the Space Center. I like to think of it as I'm the Lorax for science. I get to take people who are maybe interested in space or don't know a lot about space, and I get to share stuff with them. As an institution and as a person, I try to inspire people to look up and to gauge their curiosity and really bring that to life. My parents definitely were the biggest inspiration for who I am today and where I am today. The number one thing that they said was, be who you are and search out your truth. Ask questions, try to figure out what is the reality of it. Even from a very, very young age, I kind of had that scientist mindset of how do you know what you know and how can we learn more from that? Astronomers, when we look up at the nighttime sky, it's this sensation of humility, of awe, of the wonder and the sheer magnitude of everything. No other field really deals with cosmology, the universe, these vast sizes that we can't really comprehend. And to be an astronomer, you do have to have a little bit of peace with that. We don't know everything and we may not know everything, and that's kind of the beauty of it. You have to be curious about the world around you and the people around you, as well as the stars. And don't let anyone diminish that curiosity. If you're interested in something, you have to pursue it. The younger that people get inspired into sciences and space, that means that I'm doing my due diligence as a human on this earth to pass on that knowledge and have the next generation better than the generation we currently have. I'm doing what I have to do. It's my didactic imperative. It's my job. It's my purpose on this planet.